Hello and welcome back to this video. Now in the previous video, we have already discussed about how to use sweep with multiple guides. Okay. And in the previous video, we have already understood what will happen if I choose two guides and what will happen if I choose three guides. But there is something which is very important, which need to be addressed, and that can only function with only one guide. So here we have certain orientation method. I'm not going to go through all the orientation method to be very clear. I'm going to explain you the one which are very important and one which are going to be specific to this particular part. So there is one orientation called fixed, there is one orientation called face normal, there is one orientation called vector direction. So these three orientation method we are going to discuss today, and some of the scaling method we are also going to address today. Now some of you might feel like, and yeah, one more very important orientation method called as angular law, which I'll address today. And there were people like who are asking about the flex command. So this is kind of, you can do something in this also, like you can have certain object twisted in a particular way. So I'll create some examples later on. I'll create some designs later on. For now, we will concentrate on this options. We will try to learn this option, how exactly this option works. Now orientation, as the name suggests, it controls the way the section is oriented. Okay. So for now, let's try to create something. Let's try to create a 3D curve, and I'm creating a helix as a 3D curve. Now for helix, what I'm doing is I'm creating a helix with, let's say, a diameter of 60, the pitch of 20 and the height of 100. Okay. So diameter of 60, pitch of 20 and a height of 100. So this is something which I've created using typically a normal sketch, a normal helix command. Now, if I create something, for example, let's say if I create a circle at the very end, a rectangle, a triangle or any other geometry, let's see what happens when I try to use that particular sketch for sweep. Now, this can be also used to create threadings. Okay, so later on, I'll create one separate video how to create thread portion. Okay, so let's say, for example, here I'm creating a sketch on the front plane. A sketch contains, suppose, a circle. Okay, so we will try to sweep a circle of diameter 8. We will try to also use a rectangle. Okay, let's say of length 25 by height of 10. Okay, we'll try to sweep a rectangle like this. We can also try to sweep different geometries. So I'll just click on finish and let's try this one by one. So if I go to surface command, if I go to swept command, now here I need to select the section curve. So here in section curve, I'm selecting, let's say, my circle, and here in guide, I'm selecting my helix. And what I'm getting is a very simple output of something like this. And this can be easily achieved with one more command. I want you to comment in the section below which command can be used to create something like this. Okay. Now, if you have already commented, let me show you. You can also use the tube command. And here you can specify the diameter of 8, select the path. You don't even have to create a circle for that. Okay. So that way also you can achieve this particular part. Now the problem here is not with a circle. The problem is when you create some geometries which are not circular. So for example, here in the section, I'm selecting connected curve as my curve rule, and I'm selecting my rectangle. And here in guide, I'm going to select my helix. Now you can notice it is not going in the perfect way, or it is not going in the correct way. Okay, the output is self-intersecting. So technically what happens when you create a 3D curve and the orientation is method set to fix, so it doesn't go with respect to the way it should. Now in this kind of condition, we need to choose the orientation method called vector direction. Now in this, using this orientation method called vector direction, the software will ask me in which direction you want to fix. Okay, you want to fix the orientation. So I want to fix the orientation in my vertical direction. So now I can select the vertical direction and I can fix my orientation of the rectangle with respect to the Z axis of this particular part. And that will give me a very great result. Okay. So this is how we can use the option called vector direction inside the sweep command itself. Now there is one more option called face normal, and let us discuss that as well. Now I'll cancel the command. I'll delete my sketch. And what will I do is I'll create a new sketch on the front plane. This time I'm going to create two sketches. Okay, so I'm creating an arc starting from the top, going all the way to the bottom. And this is a curved sketch like this, as you can notice. So there is a curved arc over here. And now I'm creating, let's say, a corner rectangle. Okay, or let's say a 3-point corner rectangle, which is going to be perpendicular to my arc. So as you can notice, the 3-point corner rectangle is going to be perpendicular to my arc. Now, if you want, you can attach this rectangle exactly in the center. Okay, but for now I'll keep it as it is. And I'm going to click on finish. Okay, and because we are using NX particularly, we can create sketches like this. You know, in other software, it's not really possible. Like you can use some part of the sketch for revolve, some part of the sketch for sweep. So here I'll going for revolve. And here I'm selecting this arc and the axis will be here. So I have created a simple revolve like this. Okay, I have created a simple revolved shape like this. Now what I want to do is I want to create a sweep now. So I'll go for a surface command, sweep. Now in section, I'm going to select my rectangle. And in guide, I'm going to select my helix. And as we all know, it is not going to work perfectly. And what we have learned right now is called as vector direction. So if I choose my vertical axis as a vector direction, so it is going to maintain the same orientation right from the beginning till the ending. Now what I want is, in the beginning, it was perpendicular to my arc, or technically perpendicular to my face. At the ending also, it should be perpendicular to my face. It should not be something which is in the start. So what I can do here is, in place of vector direction, I can choose face normal and I can select this face. So here I can choose single face and I can select this face. Now you can see at the ending also, it is perpendicular. In the middle also, it is perpendicular. And in the beginning also, it is perpendicular. So in all the areas, this particular output is now perpendicular to my face. And that is what is known as face normal. And this will help you a lot in terms of creating some complex designs. Okay, so I hope you understand this particular part of, the sweep. That is how to use face normal, how to use vector direction. Fixed is something which is by default and which is normally used. Okay, now let us understand one more option called angular law. Okay, now here I'll click OK. And this is what output I'm getting. So I'll close this file, or I'll keep this file as it is. Or I'll close this file. I'll create a new file now. And I'm going to show you something called as angular law. Now, when I say angular law, so that means you can create an output which is twisting along the path. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to create a path first. So let's say I'm creating my path on the front plane. So this is something which I've created. Now here I'm creating a path with a length of 300. Now I'm going to create a sketch on the top plane, and which will have two basic geometries. For example, it will have a square first of all, like a center rectangle forming a square. So to form a square, I have to make these two sides equal and the size will be of 80. Okay, we will have one more geometry along with a square, let's say a circle next to the square. So let's say a circle diameter will be 30, and I will have pattern from this center. Let's say I will have four of these. Okay, so this is something which I've created. Okay, a square and four of the circles. Now I'll go for surface, I'll go for swept. Okay, here in section, I'll choose connected curve and I'll select all the curves here. So I know, like, having multiple loops. Okay, so as of now, I'm not going to select the circle part. I'll just keep the rectangle selected. Here in guide, I'm going to select the line. Okay, and here I'll choose fixed, and this is what is happening normally. Now if I choose angular law, okay, here I can give a constant angle. Let's say if I give a constant angle of 45, see, entire geometry is going to rotate by 45 degree. If I give a constant angle of 10, so this is how it's going to rotate. So 10, 20, 30, 40, 50. Likewise, we can give different angles. So if I keep the angle to 0, this is how it's going to look. Now in place of constant, I also have a linear way of giving the angular. So here I can define the start of 0 and the end of, let's say, 45. So in the beginning it is 0 and at the ending it is 45. I can also do something like start at 0 and end at, suppose, 180. So it is rotated by 180 degrees. Okay, so this is something which we can achieve with angular law. I can also go for cubic, so that will have a smooth output. So if I give the same angle of 45 in linear, this is how it's going to look like. In cubic, this is how it's going to look like. So we can decide what exactly we want to do with this angular law. We have more options as well, like linear along spine and cubic along spine. If you want to learn more about those options, please let me know. Later on, I'll try to create a video using linear along spine and cubic along spine. And if you haven't watched the video in which we have created a bowl, okay, in that we have used this particular option called cubic along spine. And I will link that video in the I button somewhere so that you can even watch that particular video. Okay, so here, this is something which I have created so far. Okay, now let us try something like a circle. Okay, so let us go for a swept. This time a section is a circle, which is little away from the guide, and the guide is the line. Okay, and you can see the angular law is working in a similar way. Okay, so if I give 360, so it is going to complete one entire revolution around the guide, and this is how it's going to look like. Okay, so I hope you understood how exactly this rotation function or basically angular law works. Now let us try to create something with this. Okay, to keep the video short, let us try to create something very small with this. So what we are going to do now is I'm going to start with a new file. Okay, and here in curves, I'm going to create a helix. Now I want my helix to have a diameter of 60. My helix pitch will be, let's say for example, 100, and the height will be 50. So it will complete exactly half the turn. Okay, in 50 mm, it will complete exactly half the turn. Now diameter, I don't want constant of 60. I want to make it linear. So the top diameter, what I want is 0. So starting will be 60 and the top will be 0. So it will start from 60 and go all the way to 0 at the end. I'll click OK. Now what I want to do is I want to create two circles. Here I want a different diameter. Here I want a different diameter. Okay. I can use variational sweep for that. Okay. If you remember, I can use variational sweep for that. Okay. Or else I can also use a sweep command normally. Okay. So what I can do is I can create a sketch on the path. This is my path. So here I'm creating a sketch. So let's say here I want a circle of diameter 10. Let's say finish. Okay. And here again, I'll go for a sketch on the same path, this time on the other side. And here also, again, I want a circle. Okay. On the completely other side, let's have diameter 1. So here circle diameter is very small on the other side and it is not completely on the other side. So what I can do is, I can edit my sketch. I can choose reattach option. Okay. And then I can move my sketch forward. Later on, we are going to discuss more about this option. So don't worry about it. So here I have just reattached my sketch to this particular spline at the end most point. Now what I'm going to do next is I'm going to go to surface. I'm going to go to sweep. Now here I'll reset the sweep function. In section, I'm going to select the first circle. Then I'm going to press add and I'm going to select the second circle as well. In guide, I'm going to select this curve and what is I'm getting here is this particular output. Now the output is self-intersecting sort of, so I can just flip this so that it removes the self-intersection because the arrows should point in a similar direction. So I have something like this ready. So I'll click OK and I can hide my first and second circle, also the helix. Now what I can do is I can go to home tab and I can choose pattern geometry. I can select this geometry and choose Z axis for creating a circular pattern. Let's say I want 8 of these. Okay. So something like this can be easily created using this particular command itself, using the sweep command itself. Okay. Now let's say I want to give a particular color to this. So I can press Ctrl J and I can give different colors as I want to. For example, here I want to give, let's say I want to go for a lighter shade. For the last few videos, I'm going for a darker shade. So here I'll go for a lighter shade. Okay. Then I'll go to view. I'll choose shaded. I'll activate perspective and studio. I'll hide my point. And this is something which we have created solely with the help of the swept command. Okay. So I hope you got the point how exactly swept command works. Okay. Now, if you want to see something created using swept command, I'll give you some examples like drill bit. If you want to try by yourself, you can do that. Or in the future video, we can also understand how to create drill bit with the help of swept command itself. Okay. So I hope you like this particular video. And if you want to have, if you want to learn similar things, if you want to have similar content, you can join with the channel. I have already covered some basic part of Swift in the previous three videos. This is more advanced part of Swift, which we are covering in this video. So thank you very much for watching and have a great day.